Previously on A Journey into DCC.
Okay, here goes nothing. I'm cutting the black wire.
Finally, after 2 years,
oh, sorry.
There it is. The perfect DCC system. Oh my.
Thank you.
DCC is so much easier.
Hey everyone, and welcome to the final chapter of my journey into DCC. This is a bittersweet moment because I finally get to run my DCC trains, but I'm really gonna miss filming this series. In this video, I'm gonna hook up the Zephyr, run a train, and then afterwards I'll explain what's left to do on the layout.
Okay, here is the Zephyr from Digitrax. And if you've been following me for a while, you know that about 2 years ago in a mail call, I got this system from Chris.
And this is the main thing that I bought because I'm going to start a module and it's going to be DCC. So I bought a Zephyr Extra 3.0 amp starter set. I have no idea how to use it, but it came with instructions. I think this part goes into the wall. I'm not too sure.
So the first thing I did was I plugged it in. That's the power going to the wall. In the back here, you'll notice we have some little outlets here for wire. Jump one, jump two. I guess that's for exercise, I don't know. Program A and program B. That I'll show you in a different video. Ground D, I'm not sure what that's for. And then rail A, rail B. That's what we're gonna use because rails have, of course, two rails, an A and a B, one and two. So I have two wires currently going to A and B, and they're alligator clips, which I have hooked temporarily to some feeder wires going to the depth lift. So I'm hoping that's enough power. Next, I want my track to have power, so I'm going to turn the power button on. Oh, what could that be? It's the brand new CM locomotive my wife bought for Christmas. Let's see if it works. So I already programmed it. So the track's on, the brake's on, so loco, and it's 9639 local again. Go forward. Brakes are off. Throttle. There she goes. Woohoo! We have liftoff. By the yard. Up the incline. Through the dense forest. And then down again. Okay, let's see if the air track works. Switch, switch. Woohoo! So now I can do some operations. I have this switch works. Tested it out. And that goes into here to two tracks. So I'm gonna have a bit of operations. This will be again the cinnamon plant with some oil platforms here, some industry here, some roads. Then I have the yard to finish. You can see my switches are in place somewhat. I have the shed waiting thanks to Chris. If time is on my side, I'll switch this one around so it comes off here into another industry. I'm still not sure what's going to go here. And then I'll start working on my little residential street here so the train can pass by. And that should keep me busy for at least all summer. So the Zephyr Works from Digitrax, I'm very happy. I like it. It's pretty straightforward, pretty simple. I do have some footage to show you of trains running. I promised you that last video for the 30 year anniversary of M&M Rails. So that's coming out soon, and you'll see some trains running, both freight and passenger. So stay tuned for that.
I'm sure you can guess how happy I am to finally run DCC trains. It's been a long time. I'm gonna run all my DCC trains. In fact, I'm gonna take out my old DC locomotives and run those too, because they've been sitting in the boxes for a long time. Well, that's it, the end of my journey. I hope you've enjoyed watching this series as much as I enjoyed making this series. I appreciate all the views, the comments, the likes, and all support for these videos. But just because the journey's over doesn't mean the fun's over. Be sure to watch for updates on the layout, mail calls, and upcoming contests. My goal is to finish this layout by December 2019, so that in the new year 2020, I can start my new series, My Journey into N-Scale. Ha! Just kidding. Thanks a lot for watching. Until next time, take care. My Journey into N-Scale.
N-Scale?
That's a joke.